if you photograph me, you have to get my release before you can sell anything with my fake picture on it. Okay? I watch television. I know that from lawyers. You know.
That's right, yeah.
I'm doing okay. And you?
Doing fine?
I'm all right, I guess. Okay. I'm still breathing.
No, I'm just the designated driver.
And your wife?
The wife was a
teacher. Yeah. Mrs. Padron.
I tried to get in.
Mrs. Padron.
I tried to get in and teach sex education, but they wouldn't do it.
Where were you affiliated? You taught Spanish, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
She taught Spanish.
Yeah. I remember you.
We're both Cuban American.
Oh, it's great you could come.
And I was discharged from the army in 1946. So I'm way before the Castro.
I was fat and I had dark hair.
Pretty good. How you doing?
Thanks.
Good. I'm going to wait till find out where I want to sit yet.
Oh, on the way there.
1970 to about 1975, I guess. Short time.
What'd you teach?
Math.
Oh, yes, it is.
And I'm still teaching.
So then that's
I teach at Parkdale.
Okay, so still in the system.
Still in the system. Is that incredible or what? I don't know. It really doesn't. I mean, it's like night and day. I mean, just from staff, it's different, and the kids are different. The kids are bad. The kids are out of control. We had it made back in the 70s, I'll tell you. We had it made.
I don't do the little art books right now. It's really Southern Comfort to have an art show. We do a little one.
Mostly Spanish, sometimes French, but over the years I taught a lot of different things because I taught 9 out of 12 grades. I wasn't always in high school. When my boys were young, I taught elementary, and then they could go back and forth to school with me. Then when they went up to junior high, I went up to junior high. Then we moved to Crofton, I went over to senior high. I don't know really how long I taught at Bowie, to tell you the truth, because as I said, I taught a lot of other places in the county before I got there.
Mr. Hallworth.
Hey, Jeff, good to see you. I saw your mom the other day.
That's what she said. Yeah. That's what she said.
Yeah. Hey, you look terrific.
Well, so do you. I wanted to come and see if I could talk to some faculty here about, I wanted to just get their memories of Bowie and for the class and for the teachers.
I was there from when it opened in mid-60s until 89. I was at another school before that, but I was at Bowie until the 1989. It was a great time at Bowie. When you were there and Jill, and that was a great, great class, great time.
I certainly have great fondness because
my 1800s. Oh, you remember.
More attention, I wish I could go back now. But,
Well, I think we all have that kind of feeling sometimes. Yeah, right.
Cruel. Good to see you.
How you doing, Mr. Sharp?
Great.
Nice to see
you. Yeah, it's Mr. Sharp crap. I mean, good. It's Bob, okay?
Okay, yeah. Bob. Very nice to see you.
Oh, God, I got there in 75 and was there until 98. Yep. I retired with 29 years instead of putting in the full 30. And that's because I had to for my own mental health. Well, Big Charlie here and I work together. We're both remodeling contractors, so I mean, Charlie and I connected back in 75 when I got there. And we've been working, you know, whenever we need to team up together, we do. And yeah, so it's a good arrangement. Okay. Right here, yeah.
Hi, Mr. Dodson.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Glad to meet you.
I'm Jeff. Jeff Hewitt. Right. All right.
I know your name, and it's been a while.
There it is. Great.
Yeah, that's me.
Greg with the
heart. Thanks.
Yeah.
Mr. Sharp.
Right. Well, you were in TV productions, things were.
They got the name off.
Yeah.
You were a scientist.
Yeah, in physics. I don't know if I don't think I had you. I'm not sure. Yeah. Right.
You got out.
Right.
Right.
I came there in 1966 through 1993. Yeah. Right. Huh? Yeah, from Bowie. I taught a couple years before I came to Bowie, so I was I started teaching age 21 in 64, so I was only 23 when I came to Bowie. We're all a little part of history.
Do you remember the classes on the
I can, it's hard to remember specific classes, you know, when you had, I think I've tried to figure out, I think I probably had over 4,000 students, so it's tough, plus coaching in track and doing many other things, but you remember a few students in particular, but enough, you know, personal friends with some. But if I looked, if I had my class roster and seating charts, I could look at them and, you know. I mean, I can remember, it would take about maybe 3 days and you could, it went long to learn, you know, memorize 150 names and faces, but it'd be a little tough today. But I enjoyed it. I was there during the formative years and Bowie was a great school for a long, long time. It went down a little bit, but I think it holds its own. So that's all I know, you know. Yeah, I do. I mean, my memories are all good of it.
That's great.
I know it produced some outstanding students, so.
No intention of leaving anytime soon.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm sorry, I don't know if you remember me.
Oh, no. When it's Mr. Lehman, I know it's a problem.
How you doing?
You are. I'm Jeff. Oh, geez. And where's your brother?
I'll die in the
Michael?
Michael.
He's in Los Angeles. We had each other at Tasker.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. So, that's a really neat little place.
And then I moved up to Bowie.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Wow. That's great.
And I went to Bowie. Okay, you remember my wife, probably Janet.
This is Keith.
This is Keith, yes. Yeah,
right. Of course. How is she?
No, she's fine. She just, she had a dog show today and she didn't know when she was going to be done. So she didn't plan to come. Well, I'm always running across people from Bowie that I meet people from Bowie out in the Midwest someplace when I'm camping and things like that. And the funny thing is that the person we bought our house from, I had two of her kids in at Bowie High School while she was while I was teaching at Bowie, and then we turned around and bought their house down in Harwood, Maryland. Yeah, right.
Yeah,
right. That's when I came to Tasker when the busing happened.
Okay.
No, I started at Kent Junior High School, Harwood Park. I came with the busing students. I was bus with the busing students.
Right.
Well, she was there she helped me some with the drama club. She was primarily the yearbook.
Pension check.
That was her job, was the yearbook. She liked the yearbook. That was her. I went to Bowie in 1980. I was at Bowie from 80 to 94. And I retired
part-time.
94. Then I substituted as an administrator from 94 to 99. And then my leg went bad on me and I retired completely. No, I'm... I'm the coordinator of the Anne Arundel County Disaster Action Team for Red Cross. Yeah, we raise, well, we have corgis now, Freddie Gamos corgis. And we're just having a ball.
The last year she taught, it was her son. There's a gentleman here who still hasn't seen the Eiffel Tower.
And he's going to blame me for the rest of his life. You look great.
You look fantastic. It's great to see you.
You look wonderful. Well, you put on some weight, you know. You used to be so skinny, you know. So how are the twins? Yeah, you keep in touch.
I do keep in touch. Yeah. You can even say hi to them if you want.
Yes.
I'm actually doing a video. Our reunion's next year. Our 30th is for class of 79.
30th. Yeah.
And so we have...
That's right. Amy and so many kids. That was a great class. Great kids. Well, I some of my best. Well, that was the group.
It was the group.
Yeah.
It was the group. Yeah.
The one on top of the mountain down there, who's the cook, the chef for.
Dan Ball.
Don Ball. Yeah. Ball. Yes. Yeah. So, gosh, we had lunch at his place. On top of the mountain.
In North Carolina? Yeah.
Yeah.
That's great.
So we have a cottage down there in the mountains. And, our son owns it.
Yeah.
So we just go for a couple of, you know. But, he has some place down there.
How many years were you at the
wedding? 29. I never made it to 30.
That's the standard rate. Somebody else did the same thing.
Well, I got very sick, and I was going to teach either till I was 85 or they carried me out, see? So, and my doctor just said, I think, it's stressful to teach.
I can't even imagine. I mean, back then, at least there was decorum, I think. I mean, yeah. It seemed that yes, way to yeah. me, compared to now. Yeah. How many kids do you have? Or?
We have four between us.
Okay.
Yeah. So, I was Harmon when I... Yeah.
Well, he was kept calling you Harmon. I kept saying Rainbow, Rainbow.
Yeah, since 1984. In fact, a woman called me to tutor her son, and she said, "I said, oh, she's from Bowie." I said, "Oh, I taught all those years at Bowie."
She
said, "Oh no, both my sisters had Latin, and they had a Mrs. Harmon." I said, well, Mrs. Harmon is now Mrs. Rainbow. And she said, go on.
Hi, Nancy. Hey.
Carolyn, how you doing, darling? I came in from Massachusetts. You came in from Carolina. We came in last night.
How you doing? Coach Schwartz?
Right. Yeah, how you doing? I'm Jeff Krulik.
There you go. I remember the name a little bit. Right. Well, I was from 65 to 85. Yeah. I'm still at Bowie. 1 year at a time. When it opened, 65. I'm probably the last original person. I was a baby then.
Yeah. I bet I was a sister.
Pardon?
Yeah.
Oh, poor Bowie. Just for 79, no, I couldn't be that specific. We've had so many good kids every year, and it's hard to separate them by class or category. I wouldn't do that. It wouldn't be fair to the different kids. I've thought sometime of saying to pick an all-time team, but that's not fair either, because if you pick a position and you've had 40 years to do it and you've had two each year, that's 80 people, different individuals. You can't just pick one. Right. That wouldn't be fair. Right. Thanks a lot. I didn't say that. I'm doing 1 year at a time. I'm there this year.
It's good to see you.
Thank you very much.
Good to see you, Coach.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Yes, I'm still there. Big depart. Good depart.
She works mostly country because she likes the food.
Oh, nicely, I hope. I am. I'm kicking.
I'm Jeff Krulik.
Nice to see you. That's a name that sounds very familiar to me, except you have a little more hair. Let my husband sit here. Well,
I remember one thing. I remember you used to read voraciously.
I did. I know. 200 books a year. Yeah, you're right.
I remember that.
Yeah, but not that much. I took up golf.
Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
He slept in his car. I don't know. They had a apartment.
He was homeless before there were homeless people.
Mr. Ross.
Yeah.
Smith.
Oh, Jeff. I remember.
Good
how you doing?
Good to see you.
Yeah.
How
good to see you.
Nice to see
that's
you.
Right.
Got it. Did you see my wife?
I haven't said hello yet. But you. I got to tell you, one of my favorite. You taught me.
Yeah, right. Right.
And I still tell the story to this day.
Right. Actually, one of our other driver's teachers, he would park the car and go in.
I remember that with great fondness.
Yep. We never missed.
I remember my brother taught driver's ed in Florida, and he's sitting beside this kid, and he does almost a 360 right in the middle of the road. He said, "What the hell are you doing?" He said, "Oh, I looked at the emblem on the wheel,
right,
and it said it was upside down."
They did that to Franklin. They did it on 301. God.
Turning it around.
What was like out here?
Yeah.
This girl, her father was a priest or a minister up here at one of these churches, and she was horrible. So I took her out. And we're coming back to school and made a left. We're coming up 450 to make a left in the parking lot, and it's got a green light. And there's a giant food 18-wheeler coming down that hill. He must have been doing 50 miles an hour. And she starts to turn in front of him. And I grabbed the wheel and hit the brakes, and we stopped, and the truck misses by about this much. I said, "What the hell are you doing?" She says, "Well, I had a green light." I said, "Well, so did he." She said, "Oh, my." Oh. I guess it was carte blanche when you got a green light.
That's absolutely right. Okay,
yeah,
good.
Good.
How are you? How are you?
Good to see you.
Yeah.
How's everything?
Good, thanks. Good. Doing
good.
Well.
Your folks don't own that place anymore. Where are they?
They're still in Bowie.
How are they?
They're doing well. Thank
good.
You.
Good. Just make sure
them.
You tell them I asked for
them. Oh, absolutely. I see them all the time.
Uh-huh.
All the time. Are you in Crofton still?
Yeah.
Or?
Still in Crofton. Matter of fact, we just bought a house on the 11th green. Because if I don't live on the golf course, who should? Right? That's the way I look at it. So that's where we are.
Well, it's great to see you.
73-96. All manner of math, yeah. Closed out with computer math. And then 96, thank you and good night. And that's 12 years ago. And I've been playing golf 6 days a week ever since. Not a bad thing. Not a bad thing. Somebody's got to do it. Right, honey?
Right, honey.
All right. Did you get that?
Yeah.
All right.
Absolutely. Really good.
Did
to see
party?
You.
No, that's easy.
Okay, let me go put this down.
All right.
Bob just told me who you were.
You?
Oh, my gosh.
Yes, yes.
Smart. That is so great to see
it's
you.
Really great to see
and you have a little clip. I don't remember that.
But I tell you, there's a short list of really profound teaching experiences, and typing is
praise
right.
God.
It's right.
Yeah, that's wonderful.
I was just talking with Mary about it.
Yeah.
You know, I'm like, what compelled that? Must have had some kind of vision.
Your mother probably made you do it, really. But Janelle, she's in black. And we did everything back in those old days to teach kids how to center.
you would have thought it was calculus. I mean, okay, kids, I'm going to say a pair of letters, and you go back one time for each pair, like TH. Okay, you go back one, okay? Then you would have to go E space. And you know what they would do? They would go back one, and then they would hit the space bar. And Janelle created this thing where she would kick her leg. And so now look, when I kick my leg, you go backwards, you don't go forward. And she'd go call it off to them to teach them. And of course now it's so, you know, we don't have to worry about that.
Yeah, no.
You know, we don't have to worry about that. But it was, I was a counselor after I was a business teacher at Bowie.
Okay.
I became a guidance counselor.
Is that right? Mm-hmm. At Bowie?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I had my master's and I wanted to be a counselor, but I didn't want to leave Bowie. And a lot of us became counselors around the same time with our master's. And there were all kinds of places we could go, but I didn't want to leave Bowie. I mean, after all, I lived right there, and I just didn't want to have to get in the car and drive to Roosevelt or drive to Roger B. Taney or wherever. Went on an interview at Roger B. Taney in a snowstorm. And when John Hagen said, please go on the interview as a favor to me. I don't want to go to Roger B. Taney. He said, I know you don't, but go on the interview because it's my friend who's the principal. Okay. We came out of there, the snow up to here. But I became a counselor, and...
So
that was wonderful.
But you taught here for...
I started at Bowie in 72 because my son was one. And then I became a counselor in 89, I think it was. And see, Joan Moran was a guidance counselor. I was probably the only person that ever had an opportunity to have on-the-job training, because what I would do... is I would go up in the afternoon during fifth and sixth periods when I had a special time to work on a special project. And when I wasn't working on that project with Mr. Hagen, I would go and work with her. So I learned what to do before I started. And I started in January. So I started mid-year. Thank God I had the chance to work with her. Who knows who would have graduated.
What's the best? I remember you married Mr. Smith.
Yes, yes. Bob, that's okay.
Bill Franklin and Bob Smith.
Yeah, I was going to say, you have Bob and me, and of course, Armand, was it John Hagen or Mr. Biscontini that was the principal then? I'd have to ask Bob. Anita Coster at the principal, and I'd have to ask Bob if it was Hagen, and I think it was. Called us in, set us down in front of his desk, and said, you two have got to stop having lunch together in a closed room. Okay, we will, because rumors are starting and the doors are closed. And they said, people know you two see each other, but you got to leave the doors open. We got so tickled about that after the fact. And I'll have to ask Bob if it was Biscontini or if it was Hagen. I can't remember. I think it was him. I think it had to be him, because Hagen was there. I'm sorry he's not here tonight, because... But you had the door open. I'm glad. I remember exactly where you sat. This is so funny. I remember, you know how you were in groups of four?
Right.
You were back here, and it was, you were like the last, next to the windows. So there were like one, two, three, four. I can remember exactly where you sat. I can do that about a few students. Remember where they sat.
Really? Mm-hmm. That's incredible.
I remember exactly.
That's so great.
Yes, Jeff.
How are you?
I'm good. Now, when did you graduate?
79.
Did you know Beth Thornton?
You know Beth? I don't know. Is she not here?
I think so, because she told me that I taught her in 78.
Wow. I remember Joe Blast and Elizabeth Wells.
Yes.
McCoy.
Yes.
Yeah, they were all my year. So they were big fans of yours.
Oh, no. Oh, my God. Well, I see Beth, and it's really funny that I see Beth. She manages a gym that I go to in Calvert County. And so when I went to sign up, she tells me, she says, you don't remember me, but you taught me English at Bowie High School. And I said, Beth Thornton, her name is Beth Peterson now. And she says, besides that, she taught my daughter at Calvert High School. And her daughter now is a senior in college.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's amazing.
When did you start at Bowie?
76. And I left there in 92, and I went to Calvert County from 92 for 7 years, and then I was borrowed by the State Department in 2002 to work as a high school English specialist.
Well, I remember you
had long hair. I had long hair. When I got to Bowie, I actually had to cut it because, I mean, it was pretty long. I had yeah. I found some old pictures. In fact, Philip sent me a picture where I'm looking like, oh, who is this guy? Has a goatee and all that other stuff. But.
Doing this for our reunion next year.
Oh, good, good. I'll ask.
Well, I was 79,
so a lot of my friends
have
been
just
seeing
it.
And cross country and
all that
stuff. So, yeah, how about, and Lindbeck, was Eric Lindbeck your class?
He was the year before. George Lindbeck, or was it?
Eric.
He must have been the year after. The Lindbecks were mine. I went to elementary school with them.
Okay.
They weren't
like
us. Yeah, I think we
missed
each other.
Too much fun. Yeah,
hey,
this is
really
good.
Good
seeing you.
Really
thank
nice
you.
To see you. And you're still teaching economy.
Yep, I retired this July 1st.
Congratulations.
34 years later, I'm anxious to see what the next 30 years hold. Actually, it'll be fun.
It'll be great. So
thanks. Thanks. Yes, sir.
I don't know if you remember.
We're okay.
Jeff Billings and Tom Jenkins. We all went to see a Beatles event down at the Warner Theater. Yeah, do you remember that?
No, I don't.
We took a bunch of us. It was like we were really into the Beatles. And we chaperoned us down to the Warner Theater.
No, I don't remember that.
You don't remember that?
Nope.
No kidding.
Nope.
Wow. All of a sudden it just clicked. I just remember that. Because, Matt, you took us in your free time. It was a weekend. And we went down to the Warner Theater to see a Beatles movie.
Wow. Yeah. I wish I could remember. Good to see you too. You too.
You'll have to.
And you'll have this is really neat. This
yeah.
Is a real piece of history.
I was there when they had the mass clean out, threw all this stuff out. We were just talking to Bill Ross. I saved part of it too, a particular painting that one of his students did.
Really?
Yeah, I'm still. I gotta. Before he gets too drunk, I gotta find out who it was. Maybe you recognize it. What year did you graduate?
79.
Well, this was a student, or the picture was done in 81.
Oh, my dog. Yeah, you know what? It looks familiar. The artwork looks familiar. So that was being thrown out?
Yeah. It was in a conference room.
Who was it?
I'm trying to find out. It's a student at Bowie, one of Bill Ross's.
Oh, okay.
I've got it in my office. Because I said, you know, that picture summarizes my teaching career.
I think I can guess the room, too.
Yeah.
141.
Geez, you know, I don't even remember what room I was. Across from Bill Miller.
Okay.
Actually, they kicked me out of so many rooms there. Every year it was a different
town. You were just town. A good, nice guy. That's what I mean. Or
didn't
put up with
you. They didn't allow me in the building for the first 8 years.
Where did they relegate me to?
The temps.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. In fact,
that was a blessing in disguise.
You know what? Nobody ever came out there from
that's
the administration.
Right.
John Hagen didn't even know we existed. We were going to secede and form our own high school. We're going to call it Tin City High. One of the temps? There was one that I had, which was in a low area, and we had like rain for 3 days straight. This was when Armand Biscontini was the principal, my first year. It flooded out.
That's
yeah.
A Biscontini pan.
Right around my tent, it flooded out so bad there was about 4 inches of water around it. And the kids, I mean, to get in and out of the thing, they couldn't even, they took their shoes and socks off and went barefoot so that they wouldn't ruin their shoes. And they christened the Lake Biscontini.
You need to write a book about this stuff. It's hilarious. But,
I don't think that is too.
I just wanted to tell you, I'm having trouble with one side of my garage door.
Okay.
It's so good to see you.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Well, thank
you.
Yeah, I remember Damien real well. In fact, he came back and taught there for a while. All of them. Yeah. 65. And I retired in 2005. Oh yeah, yeah. It's nice to be retired. Nice seeing you.
Many. I had some craziest job, but they did it for us.
Hi, Mr. Phillips.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm Jeff Krulik.
Oh, my gosh, Jeff. Yeah. How are you? Wow, it's good to see you. My gosh, I remember you. Oh, yeah, I do remember you. Yeah. You had long black hair.
I had hair.
Yeah, well, like me, too. Yeah.
You were a favorite of a lot of my classmates. We're
real
happy to.
Yeah, so I'll tell them hello. Tell them I'm still alive.
Yeah.
I retired in 95. I started in 1968. No, I was at Duval 4 years before that, from 64 to 68. Are you recording this? That's correct. I did always open the windows. That's right. And always wore short sleeve shirts. That's true. That's true. That's right.
I was cold upstairs. Right. No,
right. That's true.
You always knew where he was in the school. If you just, you know, stood in the doorway down to a hallway, you could identify his laugh. You know, you'd hear him laughing somewhere in that school. You know?
That's true. That's true. Social studies, right. Yeah, I remember having you in class. I do remember, yes.
Social studies is now history, right?
Exactly, that's true. It's history for all of us. That's true. Yeah. Wrestling coach, right. Right.
Yeah, went to the regionals. How many times in the state? You went to the state how many times?
Four.
Four times.
Yep. And actually, Bruce Bowser, who helped me coach, is here tonight, too. So, right.
Yep.
Right. And I think golf also. I think.
Bob Lord is golf.
Yeah, but he's not here. He's talking about. Yeah, Bob Lord. And Joe Clark was cross country and track. Yeah. Right.
None of which I did. I was not that.
Yeah, well, that's right.
You're a nice kid.
Did you have different classes?
Yeah.
Well, hello, class of 79. Instant blast back. I'm Tom Dove. I taught photography at Bowie for a bunch of years. I know a bunch of you. And it's good to know that you're still around. Yes. Yes. Hello, Todd. I hope you get to see this one. I remember you well.
Todd has actually took a video of your camera. He has footage of Bowie, including your class.
Does he really? Oh, I'd love to see that.
That was photo class.
Have a seat, Todd. Mike Twigger.
Yeah. Mike Twigger. What was your name? I don't know. Andy something? I don't know.
Andy. Exactly right.
Yeah, because we were wondering
Annie
last
Smith.
Time. She was in my photo class film, that girl.
That's right.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, what was her name?
I forgot. But she was reading the novelization of an unmarried woman.
Ha! Starring Jill Clayburgh.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Nice. Sweet. Oh, I should. Yeah, this is my photo case.
Mr. Dove.
Why didn't I become her best friend? I mean, it's such
Twigger.
I used to have the movies that we did in class as a class project, and I think I still have some of those floating around. I put some of them on videotape. Some of them got lost. I changed rooms, and someone cleaned up after me.
Well, you know what? We showed them last year at a reunion, and 5 years ago, and we went and got Todd's film, and they were amazing. I mean, he had the foresight to actually bring his camera to Bowie and film all sorts of things going on.
Oh, that's terrific.
One of the things I remember is your class, because Mike Twigger was in there,
yes,
and
Oh, right. In fact, I see Paul occasionally. Yeah, my house is on Kent Island. I went on over there to his to PRS Guitars, and we had a nice visit. I took a couple of my grandkids over to meet him.
Really?
Yeah, they're avid guitar players.
That's great. He's done quite well.
Oh, he really has.
So, Mr. Danner.
I'm seeing you walk around, and I looked at your name tag and said, wait a minute, I know that.
It's good to see you.
Clarinet or saxophone? What was it?
No, I wasn't musically inclined or athletically. I was involved with the student government.
Okay, maybe that's what it was.
Couldn't hold a note.
Oh, okay.
But I'm sure you remember. Who are some of the musicians from my
What year?
79.
Oh my God.
All you have to do is recognize.
Was it big band or orchestra?
Well, there was probably the jazz band. Maybe the Starliners might still have been going on with Joe Carley by then. I came in 77. Chris Kyle. Dick Kasabian, Richard Kasabian was in, he was in class of 77, I guess. 77, 78.
Some of the students were?
Zawadikowski, Debbie Zawadikowski.
What years were you?
77 to 86, about 10 years, I think.
I mean, who were some of the musicians, like Steve O'Hearn?
I don't remember.
Jazz.
My 60-year-old eyes can't read that.
Are you teaching still?
No. I retired from Prince George's in 98. Then I went, they had a rehire thing for retired teachers. I went back and did that for a couple of years. Did some in Anne Arundel County, where we're living. And I stopped that about 2 years ago. So I'm done. Yeah. And my wife retired finally a couple years ago. So we're just working on figuring out where we're going to be in the winter and where we're going to be in the summer. So.
Who else? Who was captain of the football team when you were in school? What year? You said 79 before?
79.
Who was our tailback?
Well, I mean, I remember
Vogels, Terrells,
Barrett. 79. So Jeff Lampert, or I think
Lampy.
He was the quarterback. I think.
No, and then
Jake King. Jay was on there, and Alan Stevens. I think John Phillips. John Phillips was quarterback.
Okay. He was a quarterback the year he was there. Is that the year?
Yes.
Phillips, Kenny. Probably some Johnsons. We almost always had Johnsons. You said Al Stevens, right? Okay.
Right.
I'm trying to think who else was with Alan. Probably, this is terrible. Who was my middle guard that year? Redheaded guy.
I just remember Jeff
Lampy? Prevac? Lampy. Lampy was one.
Right.
Okay, we have to, what year? We pick him out as a senior pitcher.
right. There you go.
What year?
79.
In a minute.
You'll have this to show in 5 years.
Good.
Funny one, Ron. Here, come here. Last year, I think. they put up a flagpole, and they said, we're putting up the first flagpole. Well, Mr. Morgan put up the first one over here when Dave Morgan was in school.
Okay.
They put up a different one, and now we have this one, which is the third one. But as people don't see a flagpole and they think we need one, and they spend all the money, they get it again. But there's another picture in the office where it has one with the first one up there. From the one there. Yeah.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Ms. Young, can I just get to the, you were the Tom Pops, weren't you in charge of
the driving the bus?
One time.
One time, was it class of 79?
I knew you told me.
I
think I was in 79.
Everybody, that's because, is there, can I get you to just say hi to the class for, because we're having our 30th reunion next year. And I remember, we had,
who were some of the people in it?
It was like some of the folks were,
that's totally different.
Teresa Devine, Marla Brickman.
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
Chris Rich.
Oh, okay.
So you just did it the 1 year?
No. I did it for several years, but it was when I was younger.
Sure. You know, we can all say that. But anyway, I'll let everybody know that,
okay.
You send your regards. Okay.
Yes, I remember some of those.
What years did you teach, Roy?
1970 to 1998. And I had some wonderful students.
I started at 81, and then I retired in 97. And then I took 2 years off, and then I came back and taught another 5 years on that rehired program. I taught science.
Had an email from Patch Wilkes, principal at Missouri, and she sent her regrets that she could not be here, but does want to attend the next one. You'll see at your table some shot glasses.
Speaking of dead,
they are from the class of 1996, so you may take one of those with you. Now, the DVD that you are going to see tonight, and also you will receive a copy of it. You probably, the only one that doesn't have one is probably Dave Phillips. If it wasn't a movie projector, then Dave did not and probably does not know how to operate. So anyhow, Dave, you'll have to remember everything you see tonight and tell Tina about it, or maybe buy a DVD player and then get Tina to work for you, okay?
Make sure you take a look at all of the composite photographs year after year that we have. And next time that you talk to Doris Nelson Burton, make sure that you thank her, because when one of our principals came in, they were all thrown out. And Doris went dumpster diving, literally, into the dumpster and retrieved them. And I went back the next day and found more and got the rest of them. We are missing a few, but in talking with Jane Spence, the new principal, she wants so badly to restore Alumni Hall back at Bowie High School. So we're going to raise funds, remat, reframe, and try to redo those ones that are missing. So I just wanted to give you some good news back at Bowie High School.
Some people were asking, just one little personal insight here. Some people were asking me what I was doing these days. I graduated from Bowie in, retired from Bowie in 93. That was in June, and then I took the job at St. Pius for 2 years, half a day, teaching computers, and teaching children of students that I taught at Bowie High School. And in fact, my daughter was telling me that one of the students that I taught at Bowie High School, that her son is in one of my classes now, which I'm teaching. But to follow up on that, I retired from St. Pius after 12 years, so that was 2005. And then the computer teacher that replaced me, she became pregnant, and so I went in and subbed and opened one of the school years for her. Then she resigned last year, so I went in and closed down the year for her. And then last year I was volunteering at School of the Incarnation, which is a new Catholic school on Watchapel Road where my daughter was teaching kindergarten. And so I went in one day a week on Mondays and volunteered in the computer lab and also in the library. And the computer lab teacher got pregnant. I had nothing to do with it. Sort of seems as though where I go, right? She became pregnant, and since I had a background in computers, she asked if I would come in and take over when she delivered. And so on September the 15th, I started teaching computers at School of the Incarnation, or as my son-in-law likes to call it, School of the Incarceration. Yeah. But it's an excellent school, and I'm the second man on the faculty there. The same when I went to St. Pius, I was the only man on the faculty there for a few years. And School of the Incarnation, they have one other man teacher, so I'm there for 6 weeks. So I have four down and four more to go. And then when somebody else gets pregnant, maybe I'll go. All right, that's all I'm going to say.
Anytime you have AV, something is bound to go wrong.